In this video, we will unleash the power of the quad cortex. We will use it as the centerpiece of my studio, using it for recording all the instruments but the drums. I will record the guitars, bass guitar, acoustic guitar and voice, all just using the quad cortex. Let's start. First of all, I've used a combined audio device in my Mac, pairing the quad cortex with my Apollo 16 interface. Then the quad cortex is connected to my Mac via USB. And in the effect loop of the quad cortex, I've connected the Universal Audio Astra Modulation Machine, just to have a specific chorus, a particular chorus that is available only inside this box. Then in Cubase I've created three stereo channels. The first one that is taking the output 1 and output 2 of the quad cortex, basically used to record the DI track of my guitar in order to reamp later if needed. Then with the stereo track 2 I have the output coming out from the output 1 and 2 of the quad cortex, and in the 5-6 I have the output coming out from the USB channels 5 and 6. Let's now share the setting I've used for the solo guitar. I've used a block dedicated to the capture I've done of my Soldano SLO-100. And then after the capture of the Soldano, I have split the signal in two. One side is going directly out to the output 1 and 2, and the other one is going into the effects blocks. In this way, I can record the amp in one track and the effects in other two tracks. For instance, these are the tracks of my solo. This track here is the DI signal. This track is just the amp, and in this track I have the effect signals. Then if we go in the delay block, we can notice that the mix of the delay is 100%. So, I mean, the signal is totally wet. So that I have in these tracks just the effect. In this way, I can decide the amount of effect while mixing. And this is very useful. These two blocks are the effect loop send and return that are going into the Astra modulation effect. Then this is the patch I've used for the clean sound at the beginning of the demo song, where I've used a Fender Deluxe amp with two mics, an SM57 and a ribbon mic that is a Beyer Dynamic 160. Then also here I have split the signal in two. Basically, I'm using the same trick I was using the solo guitar. So I have the direct signal of the amp in one stereo track and the effect signal in other two tracks, where I have just the signal of the chorus. For the bass guitar, I use a capture that was already inside the quad cortex, that is actually an Ampeg SV. I don't know the characteristics of this capture. If you notice here, we have many capture of this bass amp. I assume that is an Ampeg SV. The number 3 was the one sounding better, in my opinion, and that's the one I use, basically everything flat. For the acoustic guitar, as you may have noticed, the signal chain is empty. In fact, here I've used a microphone with the phantom power on and enhancing the level of the mic preamp. Now, one thing that is not so nice is that these parameters are not saved within a patch, so they are basically global parameter, I think. I mean, I was not able to save these settings in a patch, so every time I changed the patch, also these settings were changing. But the important thing here is that, in my opinion, the preamplifier were pretty transparent, I have to say. And for the voice, basically, I have done exactly the same thing. For recording the voice, I use a Brauner Phantom Universal Edition, where for the guitar, I use a Neumann KM184. That is basically a standard for recording acoustic guitar. So that's basically all. As you may have noticed, thanks to the 8 USB channels and to its XLR input that can drive also condenser microphones, the Quad Cortex can actually serve as a complete solution for recording a song, for the bass, the voice, and obviously the guitars, both electric and acoustic. And this is where, in my opinion, the value for money of the Quad Cortex start to become more clear. Things like this cannot be done, for instance, with a Kemper that cannot serve as an audio interface, or with a Fractal FM3, as it cannot drive microphones. So what's your opinion? Is the Quad Cortex worth the money? Please let me know in the comment below. We have now reached the end of this video. I hope you have enjoyed, and if you did it, please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell and leave a thumbs up. It will be of a great help. If you're interested in my IRs or in my Kemper profiles, you can check out the link in the card above or description below, where there is also a link to a playlist of songs of mine. Thank you for watching, see you in the next video. Bye bye!